Dear viewer, good evening and welcome to Spotlight. With me tonight, the mayor of Troy, Ethan Baker, and it's the headquarters of our office in Troy. And we are very proud to be in Troy. Welcome again to MEA.
Wow. Wally, thanks for having me. I'm excited to be here today with you, and we're very excited and happy that you're headquartered here in the city of Troy.
Sure.
It's the world to us.
Pleasure, pleasure. Ethan, can you tell me about yourself? I mean, there is a lot of ethnic minority, including the Middle Eastern, living in Troy. Yeah. And they want to know about their mayor.
Sure.
So tell me about yourself. Which college you went?
Yeah, I'm happy to. So, you know, I'm a lawyer by trade, actually, but so I've gone to school quite a bit. But I'm from California originally. I grew up in Northern California, then moved to Southern California, and that's where I started going to school. I went to the University of Southern California.
What part?
I lived in L.A. for 12 years, went to USC, got my bachelor's there in political science.
I see.
Then I went to law school at Whittier College School of Law, and I actually started practicing law out in California before moving here to Michigan in 2009 in Detroit. And since I've been here, I got a master's degree at University of Michigan.
Good.
In public affairs. So
public affairs,
I've got done some schooling throughout, but you know, most important, honestly, is my wife, and I have three kids. I love my family very much. We're obviously raising them here.
How long have you been the mayor of Troy?
I've been the mayor for 2.5 years.
I got elected
in November of 2019,
okay,
just a few months before COVID hit. So a lot of my term has been focused on COVID, but it's been 2.5 years. And I served for 4 years on city council before that.
I see. Are you running for election in midterm?
Haven't made any. We don't have elections here in the city of Troy in the even years. We do them in the off years. So next year, my term will be up, and we'll make some decisions
about
that.
So you are with the general election?
Yeah.
I see. Tell me about, you know, I see in Troy, and honestly, I've been associated with Troy for the past probably 20 years.
Yeah.
But in the last 10 years, Troy, a lot of business came to Troy. Troy become a hub for a lot of corporation and a lot of people moving to Troy, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me more about the expansion of the business and corporate office and all that.
Sure. You know, it's funny you say a lot of people have moved to Troy because, you know, the census results just came out from the 2020 census.
Yes.
State of Michigan overall lost population, and a lot of places in this area did, but the city of Troy actually gained population in this last census. And it's to your point, people are moving to the city of Troy.
I believe you have about 84,000.
Oh, 87,000.
87,000,
yeah,
great.
We've gone up a little bit. But
yes.
I think people move here because for a lot of reasons. One, and businesses move here, but residents
Let's
move
talk
here
about
too.
The business.
Let's talk about
first.
Business first.
Yes.
So, obviously, our location, you can't beat our location. You know that, your headquarters.
Center of everything.
We've got access to everyone around us, everything. We've got the Big Beaver Corridor, which plays a huge role in corporate America.
Sure.
Not just here in Michigan, but throughout the country and world.
Yes.
I think that businesses move here for our infrastructure and location, right? They know that we take care of our roads, that we take care of our businesses when they're here.
Yes.
You get a good tax rate when you're here, which I think is important to a business's bottom line.
Well, that's
line.
Important, you know, if they could get, with the city, official if they need a certificate of operation or something. A different city, they give you a hard time, but I believe in Troy, they are welcoming.
They are absolutely welcome here. And you know, we work really hard to make sure they're gonna succeed, a business is gonna succeed here in the city. We have a great relationship with our Troy Chamber of Commerce. And just our general City Hall staff, the planning department, the building department, they know how important it is when a business is choosing to move to Troy to make sure they're welcomed and they feel like they're getting good service. So we do go out of our way to make sure they're getting the inspections they need, make sure they're having a positive experience from the very beginning with the City of Troy.
How is the relation between the mayor and the city council and all that? Because that's important. If I have a business, I don't want to go to a city and the city council and the mayor fighting each other.
Yeah, well, listen, for all the division in this country, in state politics
that.
Especially, Troy City Council, Troy City Hall, we're doing well.
Great.
We're a united front on, you know, the important issues for the residents of the city of Troy. And I think we're a little bit unique because we don't have to focus on partisan politics. In fact, we're not allowed to, we're nonpartisan. The mayor
Excellent.
And council. So we represent everybody, and so we don't keep or we don't have those partisan fights coming into our city council chambers like other places do. But we have a good relationship, and I think that overall the residents and businesses of the city of Troy get better service and get better representation as a result.
Great. As you know, the COVID affect everybody.
Yeah.
Not just the families, but the business.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a lot of restaurant, there is a lot of other businesses get affected by it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how the city dealt with those businesses if they need help financing or they need different help.
Sure.
You know,
there's a few different ways we worked on that over the past 2 years. You know, primarily the city of Troy was not in the position to give individual business grants to businesses or restaurants, but we did coordinate a lot with the county to help at the state level.
Yes.
That was a big part of what
we did.
There
was a lot of money.
There was a lot of money coming from Washington in through Lansing and in through Pontiac and Oakland County. So
exactly.
We definitely coordinated with our economic development director and our economic team. But then we made some changes during COVID to our ordinances to allow increased signage and visibility for restaurants and businesses that were hurting. We made it easier to have outdoor dining and to just streamline kind of the process for keeping things going, because we knew how hard it was on the businesses.
Absolutely.
And the restaurants.
And we had David here, and he talked about, you know, doing his best to help those people.
Yeah,
you know,
and
business.
They're the backbone of our economy here in the city of Troy. We have a lot of big corporations, no question, but those smaller businesses, the restaurants, the mom and pop shops.
More important, very, you know.
They're, not only are they, I don't, you know, everyone's equal. I wouldn't say someone's more important, but.
But, you know, they, the heart, you know, of the business.
They are the heart and soul of our city, too,
exactly.
Because those small business owners are also our residents, right? They're our neighbors.
Absolutely.
And they're our community.
Yeah.
They make up our community.
Yes.
So we want to do everything we can to help them throughout. And I think we've done a good job of doing it. And, you know, there's always, it's been heartbreaking to see some of businesses have gone out of business. They just couldn't make it. And, but it's been also very rewarding to see all the ones that have done well and managed to adapt to changing circumstances in the world and make a good go of it and keep doing well here in the city of Troy.
Yeah. As I see the Troy, honestly, different state and a lot of cities, they have the crime increasing. Look at New York, Chicago, Seattle. How is the safety? And safety is more important to the resident and any business to open to you. How
for
is
sure.
the safety in Troy?
We have great public safety, and we're known as a very
That's
safe city.
That's why I asked for Chief of Police to come
Chief
here.
Of Police. I'm going to wear both hats today. I'll speak on as the mayor and on behalf of the police department in a certain respect.
Thank you.
Do wonderful things with public safety here in the city of Troy. I'm very proud of our police department, our chief of police, all of our officers. They work really hard to
no
keep
defending,
our city safe.
You know, the police and, you know.
No, listen, I was asked during the whole defunding the police process, you know, what I thought. I said, we'll never defund our police. In fact, we should be investing more in our police.
Absolutely.
And I think our residents understand and our businesses, they know that we are successful because of our police department, our focus on public safety. Right?
Absolutely.
So we need to support our police department. We need to give them the resources they need.
When I have a problem, who I'm going to call?
That's exactly
police
right.
department.
That's exactly right.
Yes.
And in Troy, they're going to come and they're going to help you right away.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, we're not immune to crime. There's crime everywhere. And we've seen an increase in crime throughout the country during COVID especially.
Mm-hmm.
But we've managed to handle it really well, I think, here in the city of Troy. And I give a lot of credit to our chief of police and our police department as a whole for all the work they've done to ensure that we're a safe community still.
Great. And not just the crime. The COVID create a problem within the family, the mental health, drinking.
Yeah.
And when you at home with the family, sooner or later, you got to get argument. An argument could be
more than that. It's interesting that you've said that, Wally.
So how is the police department working with that?
We have a strong emphasis on mental health awareness and the things
mm-hmm.
we can do. And, you know, and it evolves in a police department because traditionally mental health was not something a police department really looked at.
Yes.
But we have seen an increase in domestic violence, right? Domestic incidents.
Yes.
There's even, sadly, there's been some shootings here in Troy that were family members, right?
Yeah.
Based
yeah.
on exactly what you're talking
That's
about.
Mental health, you know.
And it's tragic and it's preventable.
Of course. Yeah.
We just have to give the attention necessary to it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm married to a marriage and family therapist. My wife's a marriage and family therapist, PhD doctor.
So
and
you understand.
I understand it. And I want everybody to know, you know, there should be no stigma in getting mental health help.
Yes.
Therapy is okay. It makes the difference for people. And you know what? We all struggle at times and we all are faced with things and none of us should ever feel alone in that. It's okay to ask for help.
Yeah. Does the city have like a department for mental health or something to help people?
Yeah.
Who have mental health.
The city itself doesn't have a specific department. Again, we defer a lot of those public health type issues to the county.
Yes.
Our police department's really focused on getting people the resources they need when necessary. Obviously, our school district plays a big role in mental health with the youth of our community because a lot of it starts there, right? We
Absolutely.
Need to be,
and
I think the more we can educate our children to not be afraid of seeking mental health treatment, the better off we'll be. So the city, like I said, city doesn't have a specific department, but we are big proponents of getting the county help, police department help, school district help, wherever we can.
Great. You talk about the school, mm-hmm. and there is that stigma of teaching at the school, the students, mm-hmm. about sex and all that.
Yeah.
And I think this is very dangerous. Mm-hmm. And I think, if you agree with me, that the parents should play a huge role in this issue. Yeah. How is the school district in Troy?
Well, let me start with this first quick disclaimer. I don't control the school system here in yeah. Troy, right? The mayor's
but in
office
general,
doesn't.
You know, yeah.
So we have a school board and a superintendent
yes,
who runs the
of
school
course,
district.
Yeah.
I think the residents of Troy definitely are big proponents of parent involvement, right?
Absolutely.
The best teacher for your kid is
sure.
your the parent, mom and dad,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
So
yeah.
I think there's no mistake in that. And I think the Troy School District does a good job of making sure parents are heard. There's problems sometimes, like there is anywhere in any organization.
Absolutely.
And we work through them, or we see the school district work through them. Parental involvement is key, though, and I've been saying that for as long as I've been an adult, and certainly as long as I've been a parent.
Sure.
You know, there's nobody that knows my child better than me.
Absolutely.
And I think it's very, very important that we yeah. keep that focus. And you know, there are things getting taught in schools that aren't always necessarily what I agree with from maybe it's from my faith standpoint mm-hmm. or my principles, but we have to be, I think, cognizant of the entire community's cultural values and what they're looking for. And it's really hard in such a diverse place as the city of Troy, which I'm proud of our diversity, to try to craft a singular focus when you've got so many wonderful cultures to balance. So I think that's the maybe some struggle that the school district goes through a little bit, but I think they work through it hard, and you know, I stand by the value of our school district and how much good work Troy School District does. They're one of the reasons Troy's so successful is that we are well known for our good public schools, and that
absolutely.
Attracts people and businesses
sure.
as well.
Yeah, that's great. The Troy have a multi-ethnic minorities.
Yeah.
Is the mayor's office and the police department reflect the diversities in the city of Troy?
Tough questions, Wally. I like it. You know,
yeah.
No. Quite frankly, no,
yeah.
right? I mean,
and why?
It takes time, I think. I think we've done a good job in progressing towards a better represented city hall and police department based
yes.
on the minorities we have in this community.
Which have different culture, different
sure.
customs, the way they talk, the way they act. If
yeah.
you have some people at your office, in the council and all that, or the police department, it'll have better relation, better understanding.
I agree.
Between you guys and the ethnic minority.
I agree, and you know, we've worked really hard in our police department to have good community policing, to help bridge that divide where there's some cultural differences, and I think we've done a good job of that so far. We're continuing to, we just approved a budget in our fiscal year 2022 and 2023, which adds some communications and community engagement employees mm-hmm. potentially. And I think that's gonna help to attract and get a better understanding of what we're missing in the different parts of our community from a cultural and ethnic standpoint. And I think that there will help get us better hiring practices to increase that mix of diversity in our police department and city hall.
Are you open, the city and the police department, to hire a qualified yeah. ethnic minorities, if it's from the Middle Eastern or
oh.
the Indian or, you know?
100%.
Yeah.
I mean, absolutely. Sure. There would be nothing that would stop us anyways. In fact, I'm all for it. And, you know, it's really hard to hire police officers right now in general. I'm sure you've seen, I mean, you know, it's difficult
absolutely.
Because a lot of
yes.
the pressure and the things that are being said about police departments
yeah.
in the country, it's hard to hire. We're not having the same amount of applicants that we used to have. So we're working hard to address that. But anybody qualified to be a city employee, regardless of their ethnic background yeah. or their culture, we will welcome them with open arms here. I think that would be a big part of our community growth if we were able to do
absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. And any office, if it's the police department or you have to reflect the community.
Absolutely.
You know, and you know,
absolutely.
To deal with them. I'm gonna ask you a few questions outside probably the city of Troy.
Okay.
The border.
Okay.
What do you think about the border opening and over 2 million? And probably with those 2 million, there is the drug dealer, there is the terrorist, there is whatever.
Yeah.
What do you think about this? And sooner or later, it's gonna hit all the states and a lot of cities too.
Sure, it'll come up Detroit, right?
Yeah.
Listen, I think that, you know, the first thing we always have to focus on is border security and the things that are important to this country and to its residents. We're a welcoming community here in the city of Troy, especially. We're very welcoming.
Yes.
I think we're a welcoming country. We wanna have immigration. We want legal immigration.
Legal immigration.
We want good people to come into us and bring all the wonderful gifts that they have coming from other places.
Absolutely.
You look, for example, you look at the city of Troy. We have doctors and engineers from all parts of this world that have immigrated here and made our city a better place.
And you welcome them.
Yeah.
You know, and they're plus to the community.
That's right.
But to come like this, illegal and across the border, that's
risky
very
for
bad.
Any community. Like, yeah. I mean, right? Risky for this country. And we have to do a better job of addressing that border crisis, as we do many crises that exist in this country. But of course, we want people to immigrate to this country. We want them to do it legally, and we want to make sure we know who is coming in.
I see. Our hope was the chief here to ask him about the crimes that increasing so in some state like a city like New York, Chicago, Seattle. How are we going to control that? And we've seen some demonstration, you know. For example, the Supreme Court judges and many. It's becoming so frustrated that anyone that comes with something that not work with the radicals from both sides, he's in danger.
Yeah. It's unfortunate to me that the extremes on both sides are the ones that are dictating what's happening for the rest
today,
of the country.
Exactly.
Because I think the grand majority of people are in the middle, and they just want to have... They just want to have safe communities.
Yes.
They want to go to work. They want to live their lives and have peace. And, you know, the big city crime, we're not unique. We're not like the big cities, right? Troy's not a big city in that respect.
Yes.
And you see it, and you think, well, I'm glad that's not happening here. But we could see where that mindset could happen, right? People are angry, they're frustrated, and they're getting encouraged to do things that I don't think normally they would do by what they're seeing, you know, what you see online, what you read online, you know, what they're being told.
And the family divided between them.
Oh, it's pretty ugly.
This has become a tragedy, honestly.
Yeah.
Today the country is so divided.
It is.
I've never seen this before.
I hate it. I think, you know, I'm somebody who wants to work with everybody, and I work really hard to even if we don't disagree on something, I want to get to know you as a person, find out what I do like about you so we can make a difference together, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
That's kind of a dying art, it feels like, right now in politics, and that's unfortunate because I think the country would be much better off like it was before when that could happen. I mean, there's many stories about politicians in Washington and even Lansing who had very difference of opinions on the policies, but they could get together and share a good story and like each other and then work together on something that does unite
them. Well, thanks God, in the state of Michigan, we don't have those radicals,
right?
You know, and if it's in Lansing or any cities or any county, you know, they're working together for the benefit of the citizen.
Yeah.
Inflation and affecting everybody.
Yeah.
And of course, the citizen of Troy, they are part of the combination that part of the community at large.
Yeah.
That's frustrated with the inflation, with the gas prices and all that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Why and today I don't see a light at the end of the tunnel to be hopeful and to be thinking that it's going to get better, but it seems like every day is getting worse.
It feels that way, doesn't it?
Yes,
it
so
does.
So tell me, how the city of Troy have a problem with this?
No, I think anybody who lives in this country has a problem with it.
Yeah.
We're all suffering. I put gas in my car and it's $80-$90 to fill the tank when not that long ago it was $20-$30.
That's right. Yeah.
You do that enough times in a week, you're really hurt. And groceries are more expensive. Everything you buy is more expensive.
Yes.
And it does seem like there's no hope. And, you know, I'm hopeful that there is going to be a light at the end of the tunnel. Whether that comes this year or next year, I don't know yet. You know, Oakland County did a forecast for their economic outlook, and their economists are showing that they expect inflation to go back down next year. I hope and pray to God that it does, because it's just not sustainable for us. We look at what it's doing to our pocketbooks, what it does to everyday people here in the city of Troy.
Sure.
It changes their activities and how they live. And our city depends on, as you know, there are restaurants and our retail. It depends on people getting out, spending money at restaurants, shopping. That's a big part of our local economy, right?
True.
And if they don't have enough money to do that because their cost of energy's gone up
so much, food and everything else is costing more money,
it will affect our small business owners here in the city of Troy. So I do hope we can get a hold of it. It's got to be a national, strategy of some sort. And I'd like to know that there's a light at the end of this tunnel. I haven't quite seen it yet myself, but I'm with you on that and hoping and praying that it comes soon.
Okay. We know there is a lot of money coming from Washington to everywhere.
Yeah.
And the state of Michigan have their good part. We were 2 years ago, 5 billion in minus. Today we are about over 7 billion in a plus, and they don't know what to do with it.
Right.
Okay. Is Oakland County getting some of that money to help the citizen of Oakland County and include the city of Troy?
Yeah, so it's good that you asked that. So Oakland County got about $250 million in American Recovery Plan Act money from federal government, right?
Yes.
And they're still working out the details of what they're going to do with that and how they're going to share it with some of the cities. And I think there will be some joint programs. I'm hopeful one of the things we can do is address some mental health issues and deficiencies with that money, as a matter of fact. And I've talked to Executive Coulter about it. Yes. City of Troy is getting about $8 million in federal money. We actually have just approved a budget that has some spending of that money, and I think it meets the priorities of what our residents have said in surveys. You know, we're doing a big park expansion for a community gathering and a big community place that's going to be welcoming to everybody in our city. We had put some money into our police department for some equipment, and we bought a new fire truck with that money, frankly, for our fire department, because public safety is what matters to a lot of residents here in this story.
How about some of that money goes to road? Thanks God in Troy we have good road. When Mark Heichel were here, I give them 10 questions about the road.
Not too far from here. The roads aren't as good as they are.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So roads are a huge part of what we need to be always focusing on. And the good news about that ARPA money, because we're able to use that money from the federal government for these other projects, it frees up capital that we have existing to invest into roads.
Good.
And about 10 years ago, 10 years ago, coming out of the Great Recession, City of Troy really put a focus on working on its Troy Roads Rock program and has kept pumping money into our roads and doing things for our roads that really, I think, have put us above and beyond where other communities are around us. So yes, roads will always be a focus.
Absolutely, yeah. And let's come to the Middle Eastern community.
Okay.
And we cater mostly to the Middle Eastern community, although there's a lot of ethnic minority like the Albanian, the Yugoslavian, the Greek. They watch us because we do a lot of interview, and we tackle issue to them.
Sure.
So,
sure.
You know. How is the Middle Eastern? They have good population in Troy.
Yeah.
So, in your judgment, are they plus to the city? Are they involved with the city? What do you like to tell them, you know, to ask them to do with the city?
Sure. Of course they're a plus to the city, right?
Yes.
I mean, absolutely. They make up a big part of our community fabric, and I think it's a wonderful
part. Resident or business?
Yeah, both. Yes. I mean, both, and we're doing really well. I do wish they were a little more involved in city government, and you know, we're always looking for people to join our boards and committees to serve as volunteers for things. We'd like to hear a little more from different aspects of our community that don't always get the representation I think they deserve.
Yes.
And part of it's because, you know, they're not used to speaking with their government officials, or maybe in the countries where they came from originally, it's a different system, and so they're not so sure how to make that happen. But to me, the better relationship we can have with all residents, including our Middle Eastern residents, it's going to make a much better city. So I'm always looking for ways that we can engage more with the Middle Eastern community and how we can really understand what they need from us as government and how they can enlighten us on things we could do better.
Good. Of course, you could use us to reach the community if you like to hire qualified people, if it's in the city or the police department, or the, you know, any department in the Troy City, you know. So you said a lot about the community and all that, but I want you to give me 2 minutes direct. You said we're looking for police officer from the ethnic minority. Let's talk about the Middle Eastern community.
Okay.
We're looking for some people to involve in the city. We're looking for some people hopefully to run our office in the city. Give that message for, because when it comes from you, and when you invite them, and yes, you're looking for, and encourage them to come.
Sure. Now I'm going to do it right here. So listen, I, as the mayor of the city of Troy, I'm so proud of the diverse community that we have here, and the best part of our community fabric is the rich diversity that we have, and that includes all of our Middle Eastern residents. And I know you maybe don't always feel that you're as well represented in our city government and our police department as you should be, but I encourage you to really to apply for some of these jobs, to come and try to meet with us at city council meetings, anywhere out in our community so you can get involved, because I think our city would be much better served by having you here with us. We are always hiring through our city departments, whether that's our recreation department, whether that's our police department, other jobs at City Hall, and we're looking for qualified applicants all the time. So please go to our website, troymi.gov, and look if there's anything that interests you that you'd like to get involved in. I can personally tell you, as the mayor of this city, that I would be honored to have you trying to be involved with your city a little bit more, and anything you can do to help us make it a better place for you to live is only going to make the city of Troy as a whole a better place to live. So I encourage you to get involved. We want to hear from you. I want to do a better job of reaching out to you and having you feel like you can be heard in our community. So thank you, and please look forward to having you apply for some jobs or volunteer positions on boards and committees, or just reaching out so we can talk about what's important to you in this city.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that. And thanks for the great job you're doing as a mayor, because I see in the city of Troy growing all the time, more business coming, more residents. And I'm proud to say my business in Troy and my resident in Troy. And you have, honestly, the best from the police department to recreation to all the department. I don't see any complaint from any resident or from any business about the city of Troy. So thank you for that.
Molly, thank you for saying everything you just said. That's a wonderful compliment coming from you, and I know what the people you've come across and you've met and you work with. So to hear you say that about our city and our police department, very honored to have you say that. And I will for sure share that with our police chief and everybody at City Hall, because I think that's a wonderful
thank
message.
Thank you so much for
thank
coming.
You,
sure.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome. Dear viewer, that was my interview with the mayor of Troy, Ethan Baker. And honestly, as I mentioned, my office in Troy, I live in the city of Troy, and I see, we're talking about the Middle Eastern community, a lot of Middle Eastern community moving from Sterling Heights to Troy, from Roland to Troy, from Southfield to Troy, and a lot coming from the, because the east side for the community is becoming the hub, you know. A lot of Middle Eastern restaurant, a lot of Middle Eastern grocery store, a lot of things that related to the Middle Eastern community. And a lot of people from the west side moving to the east side, and especially to the city of Troy. So I encourage you, if you live in a different city and you're not satisfied, move to Troy. And for the business, if you're not satisfied, if they give you a hard time, the city for your business and all that, city of Troy will come to you and will work with you in every way possible. So I encourage you to do that. Thanks for watching, and good night.